a question?
Yeah.
Who are you?
Martin?
Martin Kramer? Right. Where do I know you from?
I'm your husband. You know me from marriage.
Right.
Sally, the forgetting game. I hate it. You have no idea how much I hate it.
Okay.
At least once a week now, you wake me up in the middle of the night, you ask me who I am, and I hate it.
You used to think it was charming, you know?
I thought a lot of things were charming.
You know, Dr. Matthew Spangler, he talks about that, you know, in his book, in Marriage and Modern Society. You know, he calls it the inevitable decline from charm to nightmare.
Sally, there's no such book, and there's no Dr. Spangler.
You know, I know!
Well, why do you keep making stuff up?
I can't grasp of this conversation.
But you don't do it with just me. You do it with everybody. Last month with my mother, you made up a whole country. A whole country that doesn't exist.
I thought you'd be happy there.
But there's none. There's no Hungarian West Indies.
My countries, my books, you know, you used to think they were funny.
I thought a lot of things were funny.
Well, what happened?
Sally, you know, I was going to wait till morning, but why?
Can we wait?
No, no. First, Sally. First, I want you to know how much I appreciate the wonderful work you've done in our apartment. I mean, how you've managed to capture, in only 5 short weeks, the subtle, elusive, yet classic mood previously found only in the Port Authority bus terminal. In addition, Sally, you've somewhat mystically lost or forgotten the name of the moving and storage company with whom you've placed $55,000 worth of our furniture.
You know, it's an Italian name. I know that, and I told you that.
This coupled with the fact that you disappeared 8 days ago on what was ostensibly a trip to Gustini Brothers to get strawberry yogurt, it's all led to a certain amount of confusion.
I was at Gloria's place. I went to pick up some
all
things.
All confusion, of course, vanished with the arrival last week of this. This simple, touching, yet concise note from a Mrs. Morris Klein Fishback and Fishback. We have been retained by your wife, Sally Jane Kramer, hereinafter referred to as wife, to represent her in the matter of your divorce. Said wife, having requested that her whereabouts remain unknown,
Naughty, come on. I woke up in the middle of the night last week. I didn't know who we were, okay? For a minute, I didn't know. Without our bed, I didn't know. Without our coffee table. And then I remembered that we're the Kramers, you know? We're this couple, right? And we're staying together because we're expected to dinner next Friday by those other couples. You know, and the next Friday we're expecting them, you know, because, you know, with the Kramers, you know?
After 8 days of staring into the air conditioner, wondering which Santini brother had my furniture, which Gristiti brother had my wife, which Fishback owned my soul, a light began to dawn. Or maybe one went out. And I began to realize no one had been hiding you from me. No. Your whereabouts said wife had been unknown to me for years.
Oh, right.
And that you make a fine letter writer, a great decorator, and a perfect stranger.
We don't love each other anymore.
Oh,
we just love other couples, and they love us, and we're just held together by other couples, and we're married to other marriages, and we're just traveling in packs. 4s, 6s, 8s, and we're shoulder to shoulder. You know, we're just at each other's dinner tables. And we're just boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl. But, you know, we're close. We're so close we don't flip away. You know? I remember that we're that couple, and then I fell asleep.
You said you came back tonight to talk about the divorce. You didn't mention it. Neither did I. And the habit of being together began. But I couldn't sleep. I couldn't sleep, and I thought about it. And tonight, Sal, I've decided to retire from the games. The Olympics are over, lady. The torch is out, and you're free. Said husband, hereinafter referred to as gone, has had it.
Morning, I heard somebody scream on the subway. It was rush hour. And the train stopped dead somewhere between Union Square and Canal, you know, when somebody blew. God, it was this summer. This high, nasty scream, you know, like, it was like somebody was certain they were gonna die right there under the city. And it scared the hell out of me. And I reached my hand to my throat and it was throbbing. No, and I saw everybody looking at me, and I realized, you know, that it was me. That I was screaming, and I couldn't stop. And I don't know what I did. I just went to Christina Brothers, and I just kept on walking. God, Marty, I came. back tonight because I'm pregnant and I'm terrified.
I can't hear you from out here.
I know.
A goddamn bottle of wine to discuss a divorce.
Well, why did you light a candle?
It goes with the wine.
It was lovely tonight. It was lovely. It was like a surprise party. You know, it was like a beautiful surprise party with two hosts.
Oh. If you've got any material of your own on this, I would just love to hear it. Come
it goes
on.
Without saying.
Come on, no! Don't do that to me! Don't! Do not let this go! What is that? Come on! Can you scream at people walking out? Can you do that? Can you show me an emotion? Just an emotion? Come on, look, an emotion, please! Can you do that? Can you break something? Can you scream and try?
I can't break anything, because they're all packed!
What is
it's
that?
It's a beautiful place you never moved in!
You keep moving us, Marty! Another room!
Beautiful.
You hire a floor! I don't understand you! Come on! We would have just been up to our attic French provincial furniture
do
again!
Do you have to
you
talk
know,
like that? Are you compelled to always talk like
talk.
That? I mean, when we go out with people, I cringe.
That's
I literally
how I talk.
Cringe.
You, I
all
see
these
you!
Years.
I, you go to the corner
loud,
and you pretend you're not into those parties! You know, I see you!
What about the kids? What about the kids at school that you teach?
Wait, PS29? We talking about those kids, Marty? Where you're from? You and the embarrassing lady over here? What is that? Come on, dummy! You went and you bought yourself a new mouth and get the same old blank. It's me! Sally Jane Kaminsky. You know, I know you from before, fella. I know you from popping goodies off every open counter in the neighborhood. I know you from knocking over to Samuel's grocery with the Golden Avengers,
Sally,
you know?
I was 16 years old.
I remember your jacket, that red one, you know, with the pockets sewn inside. You come dragging out of Walmart. You were the only Jewish delegate in New York.
I didn't think you even noticed me in those days.
Of course I noticed you.
I mean, I thought it was years later when, you know.
I was crazy about you.
I thought it was Marilyn Krasny's party. You know,
come on.
This whole time. You never talked about it. You never said
who
a thing.
Who talks? We don't talk. We move. We're movers. I also saw you follow me home all the time.
You did.
I saw you.
You couldn't have. You used to duck in and out of doorways. Peter Lorre told me.
You know, I would have stopped and talked to you, but I was kind of scared of all you guys and the Golden Avengers, you know? I mean, you know, you weren't as tough as Whitey Ockish, so I was pretty scared. Could have had me at 15, how about that? Could have been divorced by now.
Whitey Ockish wasn't so tough, you know?
Do you remember our first real date, 4 years later? We broke into Louis DeLancey with a crowbar?
Thank you, Whitey's knife away, he fell apart.
Remember, we pried open the fire door at 3 a.m. Remember, and you put me up in the center of the 8th row,
yeah.
And you got up on the stage and you played your flute for me. Remember?
Yeah. Yeah.
It was like Blue Tail Fly,
yeah. Yeah.
And the Streets of Loretto.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fantastic repertoire. Yes. And above your head on the curtain it said,
Los DeLancey, home of the stars.
Yeah. Right, right. Yeah. And then the cops came. Remember that?
Yeah.
Jesus, the sirens.
Yeah.
And we had to run across town. Remember that? We had to go across all those alleys. Remember, we were out of breath. We were out of breath, and we were getting away with it. We were getting away clean. Oh, Marty, how'd you do it?
What?
Get to be so boring. You had a flute and a knife, and you wanted to be a teacher, you know? You're a goddamn interesting person.
That this heart of mine.